أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول العالمين. Dear SS1 student class of CTY group of schools, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I am Azan Abdulwasi Hademola. I'm here to take you the Islamic studies. I want you all to attentively listen to this lecture so as to maximally benefit from the lecture. Our topic for today is Ahmad al-Rasul. Reading, translation, and the lessons of Ahmad al-Rasul. This is the second edition of our lessons for this term. The previous one has been done. This is the second one. Inshallah, may Allah make it a beneficial one. So Ahmad al-Rasul is one of the facets of the Holy Quran. So Ahmad al-Rasul is two facets. Number one is 285, why number two is 286 of the chapters of the Old Quran known as Suratu al-Baqarah. So we want to read the verses, translate it, and mention some lessons that are in the verses. Let us listen to the reading of these verses so as to understand how to pronounce its word very well. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Amana ar-rasul bima unzila ilayhi min rabbihi والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. This is the recitation of the two verses. First of all, these verses are contained in Surah Al-Baqarah, Quran 2, verse 285 to 286. Let's go to the translation of the verses. Allah says in the Old Quran, Amana ar-Rasul bima unzila ilayhi min Rabbi. The messenger believes in what has been sent down to him from his Lord. So what was the thing sent to Prophet Muhammad? The thing sent to Prophet Muhammad is Al-Quran, is Al-Furqan, is Al-Bayyan, is Al-Kitab, is Al-Uda. So all the affirmation names are the names of the Holy Quran. Quran has as many as 20 names. The Quran is revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he, Prophet, believes fervently in what has been revealed to him. Wal mu'minuna kullun amana billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi. Not only the Prophet Muhammad believes in what has been sent to him, but also the believers, each one believes in Allah, his angels, his books, and his messengers. This shows that before you can call yourself a true believer, you must believe in these aforementioned four articles. This is part of the six articles of Islam: belief in Allah, belief in angels, belief in books, belief in messengers. The other two are belief in destiny and belief in the last day. All the names of the angels mentioned in the Quran or in any of the prophetic tradition, you must know them very well. Then all the prophets mentioned in the Old Quran, you must also know them and believe in them. The books which was given to Prophet Dawood, the one that was given to Prophet Isa, the one that was given to Prophet Musa, and the one that was given to Prophet Muhammad, you must believe in all of them. I mean At-Tawrat, Al-Injil, Al-Zabur, and Al-Quran. لا نفرق بين أحد من رسلي. There must be no distinction. There must be no differentiation. There must be no distinguish in between or between one another of the messengers of Almighty Allah. You shouldn't give any of them preference over the other. You shouldn't distinguish between them. They are all from Allah, sent to mankind. وَقَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرُ. All these messengers say, we hear and obey. We seek your forgiveness, our Lord, and to you is the return. So this is the attributes. These are the features that are supposed to be ascribed or attributed to anybody that calls himself a true believer. You must believe in Allah, his angels, his books, and messengers. And you must also seek Allah's forgiveness on your sins, so as to not serve as an obstacle or impediment for your spiritual progress. You must also believe that to him is the return of everything. It is he that created everything. It is he that everything will return unto. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah bodies not a person beyond his scope, which means that you are not incapacitated of what Allah is commanding you to do. Allah says that we should observe 5 daily obligatory prayers. He knows that it is under our scope. He knows that we have ability to observe them. Allah commands us to fast during the month of Ramadan, either 29 or 30. He himself fervently understands that it does not go beyond our scope. So there is nothing Allah commands us which we are incapacitated to do, except if we are disobedient to Almighty Allah. لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت. He gets reward for that good which he has earned, and he is punished for that evil which he had earned. This means that nothing goes free. Everything anybody does, be it good or bad, there is reward for good deed, and there is penalty or punishment for bad deed. So nothing was, nothing gone unrewardable or unpunished. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. This is the prayer that we Muslims must always be doing. O Allah, punish us not if we forget or fall into error. We pray unto Him to do not punish us for something that we forgetfully forget or we erroneously fall into. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. Our Lord, lay not on us a burden like which you did lay on those before us, that is, Jews and Christians, Yehudi and Nasara. O Allah, do not place on us the burden that you have placed or laid on those before us. That's the prayer. May Allah never lay on us something that we are unable to carry. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به ما لا طاقة لنا به. O Allah, put not on us a burden greater than we have strength to bear. Anything that we cannot carry, may Allah never lay it on us. وَافُ عَنَّا وَاكْفِرْ لَنَا وَارْحَمْنَا. O Allah, pardon us, grant us forgiveness, have mercy on us. أَنْتَ مَوْلَانَا. You are our Mawla. You our patron. You our supporter. You our protector. فَانْزُلْنَا عَلَى الْكَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. O Allah, give us victory over the disbelieving people. So we pray unto Him to give us victory over the disbelieving people. Let us go to the lessons. These verses are contained in Quran 2, verse 285 and 286. 2. They confirm the belief of Prophet in Allah and in what he preached. 3. The passage establishes the articles of faith. Belief in Allah, His angel, His book, and His messenger. 4. It teaches us not to discriminate among prophets. 5. Muslims should listen to Allah's word and follow His injunctions. 7. They teach us to pray for forgiveness of our sins, which can serve as obstacles for our spiritual progress. 8. They show that man is going to be rewarded for good deeds. 9. The evildoers will also not go unpunished. 10. Muslims should also pray for Allah's help and victory over disbelieving people. In these verses, we have learned a lot. If you are asked, what did the Muhammad believe in? You must say that he believes in Almighty Allah, His angels, His books, and all the sent messengers. And he believed in what has been sent down to him, which is known as the Quran. The other people that believes in it also are the believers, which everybody that wants to call himself a believer must believe in them. And there should be no segregation, discrimination, differentiation, distinguishing between one another of the messengers of Almighty Allah. We must all obey Allah. We must all listen to what is commanding us to. We must all hear what Allah is commanding us to do. We must also seek Allah's forgiveness. So those are the lessons. I believe with the little explanation, you have maximally benefited from today's lesson. May Almighty Allah make it a beneficial one. Your assignments, memorize these verses very well and mention at least 5 lessons learned from this lesson. Till we meet next lesson, next time, I remain your dear Ustaz Abdul Wasi Hassan Ademola. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.